Hey guys, Captain Beatty here, and I am with Glitch Cloud. Well, technically, this is Glitch Cloud's video, but he wanted me to start the opening. But yeah, he wanted to talk. He wanted to talk about shit that's going on, and he wants to like basically let everything out of what he knows about the whole situation around Yandere Dev and Yandere Simulator as a whole. So I'll let you take it away, Glitch.
Okay. So I want to just discuss like the general behind the scenes shit, because 2018 was a wild ride for him. Like, that was like peak of drama for him when all the, and I was there for most of it. I was working on the game when most of that drama was going on. I saw how he was reacting behind the scenes and just like how he generally would take on different aspects of the drama. He just was, he was kind of a mess when it came to the like responding to videos and such. Like I saw the Gremlin shit, like when he was working on the Gremlins video. I saw like early versions of the script and stuff. One of them leaked, I know about that, and I confronted him about it. I was like, are you really gonna release this kind of thing? And he's like, no, it's completely different, man. It's a completely different video or whatever. And then the video came out and it was barely any different than what the script was saying.
You could tell that his mindset on that video was mainly emotional, kind of expressing that he has been attacked and he's the victim. That was the narrative he was trying to push with that video, is that he was the victim and he was the one who was suffering and didn't want this, even though that basically backfired and caused more attention on the drama.
I don't know what he expects though, because he's a public figure and he's kind of putting himself out there. He should kind of expect some backlash.
That is the issue. He wants to become a public figure. He feels like he wants to be a public figure. He wants to be a face that people will recognize. Like, when I watch his Twitch streams, he clearly wants to be a personality like a YouTuber or like a Twitch streamer. That, like, he wants to be, I guess, kind of famous. That's what I'm getting from when I watch his streams, that he just kind of wants people to, like, talk to him and be a personality type. That's why I feel like he just wants to focus on that and kind of get any publicity. But I don't know if that's true. That's clearly my mindset when I watch his streams. But he's very like trying to get more eyeballs focused on the drama, and that's kind of the problem. He became more of a, I guess, influencer. And even though most of his fan base doesn't really care, they want just the game. It's all most of them want. They only go for his videos just to see the development of the game.
And I think he's just mainly done this game so it can get attention on him, because he didn't get much attention growing up. We know that because he was like homeschooled or whatever, and that was something he's been very open about in the past. And I feel like he kind of has that like, oh, I need attention. Nobody talks to me. If I stop working on this game, nobody's ever going to talk to me again. I'm gonna go have to work some job at like an office. Working with him was kind of a mess. He didn't know exactly what he was doing, and you could tell he only worked on like a couple little shitty indie projects that nobody cared about before Yandere Simulator.
What? Was more of an amateur. You can sense he was an amateur.
Yeah.
When I read his Wikipedia or wiki article about his experience, it was very like not that established. He said he worked on mobile games. He was just working on small titles for some company, unless I'm wrong. But he just didn't have much of a history with games. He just kind of made demos and never really finished them, or never really pursued them any further. You can tell he was an amateur. He wasn't really like, he doesn't know how to develop a full game, and or know the structure or the things you have to do to kind of, you know, set it up, a decent foundation. He was just kind of all over the place, kind of getting assets from volunteers and just kind of pushing it together to make sure that it makes sense. It was just clearly not organized, and even though in the videos he kind of shows that it's organized, but from what you say, it looks like he's not really organized at all.
And that's something I want to talk about too, because when I was working on the project, I worked on the game for 8 months. Like, I was part of the volunteer list for that long. And he'd give me, like, ideas for, like, projects to do and stuff. He'll throw, like, hey, do this track. Like, the Light Music Club tracks. I had not received anything from him after, like, when I sent the tracks in. They were, like, 3 months in advance. I was making sure I had my shit, plenty of time to work on it if it needed any tweaks. He waited until like the last month to tell me, hey, I want this changed because the animator screwed up or that kind of thing. And it was really annoying. And you could tell he was really unfocused and didn't have much structure in his development process.
In his, I guess his video about hiring either a game study, he said he wanted to split the load, right? That he wanted a programmer to focus on just programming while he focused on other roles, other main roles, like, you know, like music, art, animation, modeling, stuff like that, right? He wanted to focus on that, but like, you know, just make someone take the other executive job. It was clearly obvious that he was just not organized. He just didn't know what he was doing. And that's why everything is so, like, broken. That's why the game is not that great, and updates are not that great and very lackluster. Even after months, he still hasn't really released any huge updates. Around February, he did promise that Otsana would come out, right? Still not even out. Like, I thought that, you know, it's like, oh, she's finally gonna come out after all this time, because, you know, he's been hyping it up, right? That this character is going to come out, and look where we are. We're almost to June, and this character's not out yet.
And that's crazy too, about like the whole Osana thing. Like, I know, I didn't know Osana was that much like that wanted until I started working on the project and seeing all these fans like, hey, when's Osana coming? I'm like, wait a second, I'm seeing right here Dev has the whole like thing for Osana done. He's just kind of delaying time. What the hell's going on here? And that's when I started questioning a lot of the stuff he was doing. And it was just a lot. Around that time, there was all that backlash against him. He was buying out Reddit for like, what was it, $8,000? Just so he can censor them. It was so stupid.
That is $8,000 of Patreon money. Of people, and that's supposed to be funding the game. Funding his part-time job.
Do you know what's the worst part about that?
That, not part-time, full-time, I mean.
You know what's the worst part about his whole Patreon thing? He only makes like $2,000 from Patreon a month. And that was around the time he was only making like $2,000 a month. So that's like four months of work from Patreon. They just flushed down the drain for Reddit.
Yeah. And I think his current standing on Patreon is $1,950. The highest that number was, it was around $5,000 a month, which is a lot for an adult game. It's under the adult game category from the site I'm using. But yeah, it's strange how that number dipped the moment 2018. you know, that whole 2018 fiasco. So it was very crazy knowing that people like immediately turned against him when everyone started like kind of not exposing, but basically kind of like showing his true side of his character. Obviously that number has went down even more in 2020 when The Right Opinion releases his well-made video. I say that's like one of the only like well-made videos about the Yandere Dev drama. And I feel like most people should watch that video. Like, that video,
it summarizes everything very well. Even though there are some parts he's missing. Sorry for cutting off here.
Yeah, no, but I feel like that is like one of the main videos that anyone should watch if they're interested in the drama. Like the videos that, like, you know, Cows, BK Girl, me, like everyone like in like the lower commentary like YouTuber spectrum that talk about the drama, it's like our videos are all right. Like, it just kind of summarizes our emotional and mental state about the game, right? Like, oh, like how, what we think about it, how we feel about the game. That was basically our videos most of the time, just kind of thinking how, like, oh, this game's really like poorly managed, just giving our opinion and our criticism. But the right opinion video was like, just, you know, not none of that, right? None of our, you know, he didn't give his emotional response as much. He didn't give his, like, you know, opinion as much. Well,
it's because he had that distance between him, because he didn't really care about the project like before the video. He was just straight to the point with the facts.
Yeah, he wasn't invested like we were. Like, we weren't that invested. Like, that's what we needed. We needed somebody who was not close to the case to kind of give their, you know, their evidence, their opinion on everything from an outsider's perspective. So we really needed that video, and it kind of sold our point a lot. So it makes me happy that that we got what we wanted, was that we wanted someone to like structure a like video, because that video was what started in 2019, right? That's a huge project, from what I can tell. Like, that The Right Opinion video like probably took a long time, which I respect. So it's like, that's something that most people couldn't have done. And I respect that video.
And that's kind of something that I have an issue with the community around, like, the drama and stuff, is they'll constantly just regurgitate the same points over and over and over again, to the point where if you're looking for new information on him and you're trying to prove some points, but you have to dig through the same shit and just a bunch of dirt.
Yeah, that's why, like, me, Cows, and BK Girl, we stopped in 2018. We stopped our videos because there was no information. We made our videos when that information came out live. When new information came out, we made those videos too. But we're not going to be regurgitating the same content as those videos already existing. So, like, it's kind of hard to find new videos that are, you know, that came out at that time. Because most videos now are kind of just, you know, remakes, basically. That's why I stopped the drama. That's why I left a while back. I focused on doing my own videos because I was done. I said what I needed to say and I left. Cows left, Big Girl left. We're done with that drama. But obviously we're going to speak about it when, you know, we have the opportunity. But in terms of videos, we are done making videos on that drama because, you know, it's meaningless to us. Or not meaningless, but, like, it just doesn't, you know, we did what we wanted to do.
And
we sent our message across.
And I think that's a general issue with, like, communities around drama, is they'll get so, like, hyped up and, oh, we're finally in this, like, this movement of, like, a bunch of information's coming out. We need to keep making sure there's more and more information. And they'll dig really hard. Like, they'll go to the point where they're doxing people, which I do not agree with. I've seen that, I think it was Cleveland that got doxed, which is one of Dev's mods. And over just, like, them being generally involved in the project, and I was like, you guys are getting really desperate for information on Dev, and I feel like that's really unnecessary when it comes to this stuff. And it kind of paints everyone to look like the bad guy, and that's giving Dev more fuel to hate us and not it take really, anything we're saying. Oh, sorry.
Oh, okay. So obviously I could look at this as more of, like, the videos that most people made are kind of, like, in the middle, like, more of a centrist point of view, right? Like, they're like the videos that we made, we weren't really that angry. Even though I was for a little bit, I wasn't the hostile. I gave, you know, him the benefit of the doubt most of the time, or I kind of, like, you know, was just kind of direct with my points and arguments. And I didn't choose a side. There's, like, one, I feel like there's two sides, right? There's, like, you know, you're pro Yandere Dev and then you're anti Yandere Dev. Which most of the time, if you're, like, very anti Yandere Dev, I feel like to the point where, like, you become more like Data Digger, which is very bad.
Or Osana, like r/Osana, yeah. Where just this cesspool of just the same information and spaghetti code memes over and over again without them knowing the full context of, like, the code. Because people will throw out that same point over and over again where they're like, I hate the code's actually garbage, without actually knowing why the code is garbage.
Like, I understand the code's, like, really bad. The foundation's not that great. He's not working on it. He's not improving. I get that. But, like, if you're not going to, like, bring up any new arguments, then what's the point? Like, that's why I didn't make a video. That's why nobody has made a video in this community, because there's no new argument. We got our point across. Everyone has to understand that this game doesn't look like it has a future. It doesn't look like there's much progress being made, so there's no point. We know that this game's probably going to fail. That is our assumption, or my assumption and some people's assumption. So, like, what's the point? All you're doing is kind of causing harm. The people who are anti-Yandere Dev and are just kind of, like, trying to dox him, trying to, like, just basically cause tons of uproar, is, like, not really helping the cause or helping the point that we're trying to, like, make the game better. We're trying to make the game, you know, we want him to understand that, like, what he's doing is not okay, and what he's trying to do is, like, it's not helping the game at all. If he keeps this up, the game's not going to be done at all in this decade, by the looks of it, because the game's not even a demo yet. The game's just kind of like an alpha, right? Like, the game doesn't look like it's gonna be done soon.
Like, this shit's in, like,
tons of promises, and
this shit's in, like, Star Citizen, like, lane, where it won't be done for another, like, 20 years if it ever gets done.
Yeah, I feel like that's what, you know, the poor organization and his mindset is what's really holding back this game. You know, people only care about the game, not Yandere Dev personally. That's why when he made that poll, what should he do? Address the drama or focus on the game? And most of the time, people cared about the game. People didn't care what was going on behind the scenes. Most of his fans just wanted the game. That's all they really want, just the fucking game.
And I feel like that's what a lot of the community is like losing, is that people want the game. Like, the entire reason people got involved in this drama is not because nobody cares. It's not like anybody really cared about Alex before this shit. They want their game.
Yeah, they funded it. They gave this game tons of attention for so long, and they're not getting what they invested. Obviously, like, when you pay a project, you know, if, like, you fund a Kickstarter, right? Obviously, you invested that game, invested your money into that game. You want that game to be finished because you were promised the thing and you invested your time and money and attention. The people who obviously donated to his Patreon and hyped this game up clearly want their investment to be successful, but obviously, by the looks of it, things are not going to be like that. So that's why people are very angry, because they were promised a game and it's not going to happen. And by the looks of Yandere Dev's history, like, it doesn't look like this game will be finished, because his history proves that he's not really competent as a game developer to kind of finish a game.
And he's a director, that's the thing. Like, he's just directing the project. But as a director, I feel like you need to have a vision. And he doesn't have a clear vision when it comes to this project. He constantly, like, keeps changing, like, oh, I want to add this feature. I played a new game. Oh, I gotta add this whole new system. Like, it's really unnecessary. You need to have, like, a clear... Oh, what do we call it? Like a path right in front of you to show, oh, I need to get through this hurdle, this hurdle. And you need to know what your end goal is. What kind of game do you want to make in the end?
Yeah. So he had a plan. Like, I feel like he would be a good director if his execution was better. Like, he clearly has some good ideas that could be fun in a game, but his execution is not great. His implementation of these ideas in the game are not great. So that's what really hurts him a lot, and it makes me sad, because this game had potential, because I followed this game from the very beginning when he made that little demo, his first video. That's when I actually, found out about it. I was very interested in the game, but it's just sad to see how it has become, and it's just like a cesspool and a little echo chamber that he's created with his fans.
And it just, like, fundamentally is not a fun game. Like, you'll play the game right now, and what's there to do? Like, there's no structure to the game. Like, you could probably, by his logic with how he's, like, structured the game, you could probably kill all the students in the first week of the game and never have to worry about them as obstacles in future weeks when dealing with other rivals. And I think that's a big issue.
But it's clear that his community is kind of, like, excusing his... there's people who do care about the drama and defend Yandere Dev. But at this point, they're kind of giving him an excuse, a way to escape and, like, be like, yeah, what you did was okay, or, you know, was horrible, but we're going to give you a pass, right? They're giving him a pass. They're trying to, like, think that what he did was okay, make him think, because they're constantly reassuring him that, oh, what you did was bad, but we'll give it a pass. We'll give him an excuse, which is really annoying that people will give him an excuse and not make him understand what he did was wrong and make him learn. Because he's a grown adult. Whatever, all the shit that he did online, he was not a kid. He was an adult, and he understood what things he was doing and saying was not okay, and he clearly didn't have a chance to even learn. Because you can tell the things that we found even before Yandere Simulator, he was still getting bullied online.
Yeah, we found old articles where they were bullying him for his weird. What was it, his hentai game profile or whatever? Yeah. He would do, reviews.
He did. I think he uploaded videos of, him playing a game, and I think people were shitting on him, saying, oh, this guy does not know how to play this game at all. I forgot what game, but I feel like Glitch will pull it up, but, basically, people were bullying him back before Yandere Simulator was even a thing. And it was very sad. He was just constantly being harassed even before this game was being developed. So I feel like he had some bad blood to begin with. So he clearly has a negative mindset and is stuck in a dark place. He's constantly digging a hole for himself, and it's only getting darker for him. So he's constantly being stuck in a well of negativity, where that well is being filled. Constantly, it's hard for him to escape that mindset. In the surface level, he's very positive from the stream. You can tell he's very happy and he's very positive, but inside, he's kind of just very twisted, dark, and very manipulated. So he can be like that, which is very sad.
And he'll go out of his way to, like, start stuff. That's my big issue. Like, what was it? Who's that developer from Skullgirls that he went out of his way to contact and in the end just started arguing with? Was it Mike Z? Is that his name? Was it Mike Z?
Let me see. But keep going.
Yeah, Mike Zalmont. I feel like that. I don't know if I said that right, but it's Mike, yeah.
Yeah. He'll just go out of his way to, like, start stuff. Like, even with nowadays, he hasn't changed at all. He'll go out of his way to send out his mods to go, like, stalk, like, people that make videos on him and such, just to see what their next move is or whatever. Like, he has this weird, like, mentality when it comes to handling stuff like this. And it's not healthy.
Yeah, he's in a mindset where he can't really take it, you know, he can't take criticism. He really can't, and it shows. He thinks any criticism, even if it's good criticism, is very negative and very hostile. He has a really defensive mindset. It's kind of hard to understand the psychology behind him, but, you know, I'm just an amateur, but, you know, it's clear that he is very, very, like, I guess, mentally ill. He's always, I guess, hurting himself. He even threatened to kill himself because of the way he's been receiving, you know, negative criticism. He just was constantly kind of hurting himself, not physically, but just mentally. He's been hurting himself and reassuring himself that what he's doing is okay, and maybe people will pity him, and maybe people will stop, you know, criticizing him if he played victim.
And I think that's, like, a huge issue with him, is he'll try to say, oh, there's, like, a distinct line between the haters and the people that are actually criticizing me, like in the Gremlins video, but he never distinguishes who is which. Like, he's like, okay, these are the haters, these are the people that stalk me or whatever. This yeah. is all the haters, everyone's stalking me. I have like 50,000 people following me at all times. But
he merges the haters and the people who give actual criticism. He merges the two, so that's why people went out of the way, like his fans, people went out of the way to kind of harass actual and silence actual criticism and good points. He kind of did that to merge the two, so people couldn't really do anything about it. So he kind of just suppressed that idea.
He never distinguished who the critics were, which is what really annoys me about that video. Because you could say all the stuff like, hey, don't harass me or whatever, but if you're saying, okay, there's a difference between haters and critics, and never give the critics' side, then everyone's just going to think everyone's a hater.
Mm-hmm.
I just think it's a little messed up. I think a lot of the volunteers that are currently working on the game have a lot of, like, passion and effort that are being put into their work, and they're not getting much out of it. And I feel like they need to. There needs to be... Mm-hmm. People need to start picking up the volunteers from Yandere Simulator and letting them onto better projects, because right now they're not being treated right. They're constantly being rushed by him. It's just a mess over there. So, any overall thoughts on just like this overall thing?
Well, but I don't really want to sound like a broken record, because everything that I ever wanted to say is always in my videos, that he's very... Without sounding like very, like, I don't know, like very like repetitive, but he's very insecure. He doesn't want to take criticism. He doesn't want to improve. Everything that anyone who wants to have a suggestion on how he can improve his game is considered hate. You know, people be like, hey, you should do this instead of this. He'll consider that as hate. He can't improve on his game. He cannot improve on himself. He already locked himself away in his mind. You know, he's stuck in his little echo chamber that his mods kind of like support. So he's kind of just stuck in this, like, I guess, ring of, like, positivity surrounded by hate. So he's just kind of stuck. He's really, like, he can't really progress.
And that's what really annoys me.
It makes me feel...
He made this whole echo chamber because the entire reason I was cut from the project is because I started questioning him on shit. I was like, why did you buy out the Reddit? How much did you pay for the Reddit? The thing that killed it for me was I released a screenshot of me asking how much he paid for the Reddit. And he got so mad at me because he did not want there to be like any public response from him on that thing. I was like, why wouldn't you want to address that? That's a public thing. I don't know.
All right, to really wrap up my idea is that if people really want to look into more of this drama, it's everywhere online. when people like present your evidence, right? People like always say that to me in my comments. I still get comments this every day. I wake up and I see my phone. It's like, oh, comments, tons of comments. People are like, explain your evidence, explain your argument. I'm like, just look online. I know that's a weak argument, but like it's everywhere. You can look it up.
And don't like, dismiss all, don't dismiss whole pieces of evidence just because you don't agree with them completely.
That's what mostly they do. I remember like this like 10-year-old kind of paid her friends to kind of like harass my video, which is very funny. And then I kind of talked to one of them and he's like, oh yeah, one of them is her older sister. And like, yeah, my sister's really mad that you made this video. I just kind of accepted her like $10 just so I like just to make you mad. I'm like, I'm not mad, but like I find that funny. But people are going out of their way to kind of like dismiss, like just kind of like suppress evidence and arguments because they don't disagree with or agree with them. So it's very funny, but also very sad that this is the community that he has built up and supports.
Thank you, Beanie, for joining me on this like discussion. Hopefully,
yeah, of course.
Hopefully, a lot of this dies down. Hopefully, Dev starts to learn his lesson, which he probably won't because it's been like 10 years. He's like the same guy as he was 10 years ago.
Yeah. Hopefully, I see improvement because a bit ago, I thought I was seeing improvement because he was very quiet and wasn't really getting into trouble. But I realized he probably has been getting good at trying to keep that inside, trying to keep all that quiet. So maybe he isn't learning, but we'll see. Only time will tell. Obviously, I won't be making any more videos on the dude until like something important or big happens because I'll be watching from a distance while I'm doing my own thing. I'll be keeping my eye on this, you know, whole debacle, just to see if there's anything that could be said or done. But you know, I said all of that I need to say. No need to say anything else. If people are looking for evidence, it's everywhere.
And like that, I feel like a lot of us need to move on. We need to go.
No, I moved on years ago. I moved on 2 years ago. Yeah. 2018 was crazy, and it was like a wild time.
Hopefully, we don't see this happen with other future developers. Hopefully, don't see any more volunteers being screwed over by him. And like that, all this is over. And I'm gonna go move on and make other kinds of content. If you guys want to support me or Beanie, hit that subscribe button. His channel's link will be down in the description below. All the music and recorded footage will be credited down in the description also. Hope you guys have a nice day.